There's a lot that goes into why they deny. A huge reason is that they would have to acknowledge that they did commit a genocide, and they would also have to give reparations, which includes giving lands back to Armenians that they lost, the Armenians lost in 1915 to 1923. 100 years of denial is not easily forgotten. Turkey's president, their entire government, it's been the same policy. You can get imprisoned for calling genocide. Calling the Armenian genocide a genocide in Turkey. Honestly, the United States' compliance in also denying the genocide happened from the federal government, that plays a big part of it as well. Turkey is a powerful ally with NATO, with the military bases that we use for the United States. So I think all of those reasons, they don't want to cause further unrest in the Middle East. The Armenian genocide was recognized fully. We'd say, you know, maybe the Holocaust didn't happen, maybe Rwanda didn't happen, maybe Darfur, all of these things, they keep happening because we don't fully recognize what's happened in the past. And I think what is happening in Syria, what is happening all over the world is still genocide. And this is why it's not just the Armenians that we are marching for and we're demanding justice for, it's for people all over, for human rights.